Hello, I am just trying to make a Easter basket from scratch. I don't really get out to get Easter baskets. I apologize for the wind making noises in the background. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a brown bag, just a grocery bag. And I don't want the printing on this side here. What I want to do is just cut that off. So I just want the bottom of the bag from here down. So I'm just going to cut this off. And I got a pair of these shears that are very, very old. They were my mom's. They're called pinking shears. So I'm going to use those and see if I can just a cool line. Let's see if I can do all at once. Aside, we will be using the back of this later, so I'm just going to put that aside for now. Okay, ooh, extra piece. So now that I've got that cut, I want to open it up. Indentations here, so I'm just going to fold them the opposite way. There we go. Hopefully that stays. So now we have a basket, and it has the edges that are kind of grass-like. And then we can put some tissue inside it. And what I'm going to do is I can make a, put aside for just a second, I can make a handle for the basket by just attaching this, go around to this side. And I can do it in two ways. I do have a backup if this does not work. So what I want to do, let's take this again, extra piece, and I want to just cut. Doesn't matter. Apologize if this is too loud. Now it doesn't matter if there's writing on the side. Excuse me one second while I get that. Do that, take care of it. Back on. Okay. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to just cut it. You can use regular scissors for this, they don't need to be pinking shears. It's just what I happen to have. And what I want to do is I want to see how long to make this. So I can make the handle like this on it. But I don't think I like that so much. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to roll it. Twist it. You can do it any way you want. You can leave it flat. I want to twist a little bit. Twist it. Squishing it and twisting it. Really doesn't have to be too fancy. Maybe a little bit longer. That'll be good. So I don't need this, the rest of this, so I'm just going to cut that off. Again, you can use any scissors. Put that aside. So once you've got the handle, let's see if I can staple it on. That's a wee bit loud. And there you have the handle with the basket. Let me just fix the side here. Sorry, that's so loud. Okay. So we have our Easter basket. If I can show you. There it is. You would fill it with tissue, but it's kind of plain, so, excuse me. What I want to do is I want to decorate it. So, I'm just going to fold it down. Like that. And I have some stickers that I want to put on it. I have little chicks and eggs. I put a couple of those on. Excuse me. And we have a pretty Easter basket sticker. It's lovely. I also have some other Easter stickers. Well, you can see that. I hope it's focusing okay for you. And some other spring and bunnies and things that I've put on. I'm not sure if I'm going to be using all of these. I'll just pick and choose. I also have some other stickers from a sticker a day calendar that I have. So I found all the ones that were Easter-like. And So I'm going to just put these out and see which ones I want to use. Now I'm going to have a lot of sides too. I'm going to do this side, not the bottom. I'm going to do this side. You can also, if you don't have stickers, you can also use paint, crayons, markers, colored pencils, anything you like. You can even just use regular pencil or pen. Doesn't matter. It's just the thought. Okay, so I think I'll start with, I do like this Easter basket thing, so I'll start with that and put that in the middle. Each individual thing has a sticker on it, so I'm going to start with the big basket. And this whole thing is down here, is a sticker. I'll place that here. So that's what it's going to look like. You can do it standing up if you wish. And these can go anywhere. I'm going to stick one up in the corner, like that. One in this corner, like that. Put one down the bottom, sort of frame it. And this one down here. There you go. Now you can just let that go as is, but I would like to decorate it a little bit more. So, let's see. I think I'm going to put a bunny. I'm going to use this bunny. One on each side. Go. And a couple of eggs around. Doesn't matter where they go. Yeah, into whatever you like. Excuse me. And then we'll put maybe a couple of ducks because they're adorable. And they'll be talking to each other down there. And then we'll put some ducks on this side. And give them a couple eggs as well. Whip. Wherever it lands. You can also put a couple of chicks up here. Well, we're going to wait on this side. We're going to start on the other side. Let's see. I'm going to actually put a little Happy Easter sticker. At the top. See that? A little difficult to see because it should be going on white background, but that's okay. And I'll give them an Easter basket. You know what? Two Easter baskets is good, since I have them. There we go. A couple of eggs strewn about that fell out of the basket, perhaps. Easter hats full of eggs. Put one on each side. And about a couple of chips. Okay, it's just, they're adorable. These chicks, unfortunately, I'd have to get tape for their little feet. They're adorable. I'd have to get tape for these because they're not really stickers. So I'm gonna stick with stickers for now. I can use tape, but you know what? I want to make this as quick as possible here. I'll save that for another time. There's going to be plenty of Easters. Let's see, so then I can put, yes, I'll use some of these. Hopefully these are stickers. Say, well, that's a good sign. They're in another thing. Keep them nice and fresh. This is a beautiful saying. It says, when you were born, the world became a brighter, happier place. I like that. It is a sticker. It's quite thick as well. I'll put that one right here. That's beautiful. I like that. It's lovely. Okay. Now, let's see, and I'm gonna put a couple of bunnies, I think, just peeking over. Checking out what's going on. A little pink one, well, actually a little hat, and this one's got a little bow, blue bow. Put that one up here. There we go. Once you put the tissue in here, stay nice and straight. So this, well, we can do these sides too if we wanted to. You know what, I could do that. Yeah, I'll put a couple in there. We'll take this bunny. Lots to decorate, so you can encourage others to help you. Put that there. And then we'll put one on the side here. And we'll do some Easter eggs in the grass. I think that would be good. Oops. It doesn't have to be perfect. Lovely case, and then you want to fill it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap some of the items that are going in this bag. So I'm just going to clean up this mess and we'll be right back. Okay? Okay, I'm back and I've got some wrapping paper and some tissue. I'm going to show you what I'm doing with the tissue. Oh, before I do that, I told you I had another way if I didn't want to roll the bag, because I did have another bag that I found that had, let me just get it. This bag here, it's, unfortunately it's torn, but it does have these handles. So what I could have done was just put, took these handles off, and then put them on either side of the basket and use those as handles. That was another option if the other one didn't work out. But it worked. So we're good. So I'm going to put the tissue in the basket. I've had this tissue for, oh my goodness, I can't remember how long. And it just, it seems to last forever. So I just take it in the middle. Like that. And pop it in the bag. Excuse me. And the cat wants to be a part of everything. He's a good kitty. He's just nosy. I'm gonna need a few of these. So it's still coming off. Might have to put a little glue on that one. Okay. Go. And then take it from the middle. You want to keep it poofy. Pop it. It's going to stay firm. The sides are going to stay up. It's going to be good. outside while I wrap the gifts. I don't need the tissue anymore. Keep 3 sheets and you're done. I'm going to put that aside. Now, first things first, we have the wrapping paper. Okay. I don't know why that keeps coming up. I'll try that. I have some smaller pieces that I've used before. These are the leftovers. Let's see if any of my items will fit. Excuse me. Okay. We have Sour Patch Kids gummies. They're little, actually bunnies, Sour Patch Kids bunnies. Aren't they cute? I have those. We have Sour Dudes, Sour Straws. Made from real fruit juice. It's blue raspberry, strawberry, sour apple, and lemon. So that's those. I like sour. Okay. Then we have Sour Belts, the rainbow berry flavors, made with real fruit juice. Some Sour Dudes. The guy looks crazy. I love that. He's crazy. Look at him. Crazy. First sour, then sweet. There's those. Let's see what else we got. Oh, yes. We have powdered candy in carrots. Like a sweet tart dust. Now these I probably don't have to wrap. I can probably just pop each one out and put it in the basket all around it. So it's festive. They got the little tops on them. And there's 8 of those. Let's see what else I got. Okay. Oh, I have Chewy Lemon Head. It's a 5-pack. And this one is the fruit mix. And let's see. It's just assorted fruit. And there's 5 boxes. I can also split these up too and put them in the basket. I might just do that with the carrots and those. No need to wrap those. And we got some Junior Mint eggs. Because she likes Junior Mints. Those I have to wrap because they're not individual. And some candy bracelets. And again, I can take these out and place them because they're individually wrapped. Okay. So actually, things I'm going to take apart, I'm going to put here. And I'm going to do the red things apart and the carrots. I'm going to wrap the rest of these because I can't take them out. Let's see if there's anything else. Oh, yes. Oh, there it is. I know she likes pumpkin seeds. So I got some all natural pumpkin seeds. Those need to wrap. And lastly, Smarties Sweet Tart. Happy Easter. This 4-pack, and I can probably take those out as well. Let's go with those. And that's it for that. I also have some smaller items that you can use. That's the candy that's going in the basket. I have some smaller items because she's a baker and she needed a few things. So I got, I got this, it's a color gel, I think, of some kind. It's a coloring anyway. It's brown. Something she needs for baking. So I got her the brown, which she needs, and the black that she needs. Sealed. I didn't even check to see if this one was sealed. I'm sure it is. Yep. Okay. And then she needed some other colors, I know. I know for a fact she needed red, and these just happen to be food coloring drops. So we're red, we got pink, we have blue. And it says you can make a lot of different colors with them. You can make this one. Let's see if it's good. It tells you how many drops to use to make that color. And these are all the colors that are in this packet. There's only three, but it can make a multitude of different things. Let's just get that too. All right, so we'll get these squared away and wrapped. These I'm going to leave separate. I don't really need to wrap those. They'll just be in the bag. Okay, so I will start with, let's see, whatever will fit in this. This will. So I'm gonna start with the pumpkin seeds. You can use plain paper if you want and then color it. You don't have to use wrapping paper. I just happen to have this. And this wrapping paper just has a lot of just, doesn't say happy birthday, it just, you know, special and fun. So. And, oh dear, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to get the tape. I can't believe I forgot that. One moment. I'm just gonna grab that. Just excuse me one second. So sorry about that. So I need a piece of tape. Thank you. It's always a little more difficult to wrap things that aren't squared. That'll be good. That'll go in the basket. Let's see, this here is a larger one. Let's see, I'm gonna take the larger. Yes, actually, I can just fold this up, place a piece of tape on it to hold it down so it's easier to wrap. There we go. This is driving me a little bit crazy. Sticking up like that. There we go. Another one. Now I can. Open a new one. Go. There. Oops, trash. Okay. Have these to do. So I'm going to just. Oops, excuse me. Take the biggest one, which would probably be this. And then just cut it. Later. Okay, the battery died. I'm so sorry. I had to switch. I thought I had another one charging. But anyway, I'm so sorry for the inconvenience. Oops, sorry. I put the microphone back on. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to finish wrapping. This was the strips, the sour strips. Oh, ripped. And these things happen, not a big deal. Not like they're going to rip it open anyway, right? Just the best you can. Can't really tell them, it's just staring at it, and if they're worried about it, then they don't deserve it. My opinion might not be everybody's, but thing there, I don't really care for. Telling you, tape fixes a multitude of things. There we go. Okay. We have this one. Let's see. Will this fit? Yes. The awkward wrapping ones first, because it's a little awkward wrapping. Go. And then we have these two left, so I'm just going to cut another piece. Should be able to make two. Cut again the long way. Should be good. And okay. right. Should cover this one, hopefully. I like the nice box ones because they're easier to wrap. So you save those for last, because when you get the ugly ones when you're all tired, they're ugly, but the ones that are difficult to wrap, you don't want to do it. But you look forward to the easier ones. So you get the bad ones out of the way first. They're not bad. I'm using the wrong words. I'm sorry. The difficult to wrap. There you go. Well, for me anyway. I'm sure others are just excellent at wrapping. I myself sometimes challenged. Which is why I like bags too. Because I put any shape in there. And the last one. And it does fit perfectly. Hoorah, hooray. There we go. So what I'm going to do is package them up in the basket. So I'll take my basket. Let me see if I can raise the camera a little bit so you can see better. Let's see if I know how to do this. Not that bright, but I'll try. Oh yeah, there we go. Whether or not this stays is a whole other story. No. Seriously? It's not gonna stay? So sorry, I tried. I'll do the best that I can. I'll show you what it looks like. So I'm gonna start with the wrapped presents. finish up with the other. Anywhere. Then we have the two lemonheads. But this can be powder in there, and those can go anywhere you want. Just pop them in. Surprise, willy-nilly. Snapped. Nice big Easter basket that they can take. So, I hope you've enjoyed this. And inspires you to make your own Easter basket with stickers and have the kids help you or whatever you want to do. It's great fun, and you can get inventive and use different things. You can even use rope if you don't want to use the twisted up bag. I just figured I had the bag and might as well just use it. And that should look great. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, please like, comment, subscribe, and I appreciate you watching. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.